This week on Walton Entertainment, the Monroe Art Guild celebrates Monroe through photography. Several businesses have their ribbon cuttings, adding to the vitality of our community. And don't forget that this week is homecoming week for Monroe Area High School. So be sure to come out Thursday and show your support during the downtown pep rally and parade.
I'm Tyler Gregory. I'm the new director at the Monroe Art Guild, and this week we are opening Monroe Celebrates Photography, which will be open for the month of October at the Monroe Art Guild, at the Eulalia, the Sunroom at the Wayfair, and the Cotton Cafe. And with me right now is one of our artists, Stephanie Calabrese, who is featured here at the Monroe Art Guild, and you can see some of her pieces behind us. And Stephanie, would you like to tell us a little bit about your show?
Yeah, sure. Well, the show is called Hometown, a documentary of Monroe, Georgia, and I first started working on this series about 2 years ago. In doing documentary photography, I've traveled to different parts of the world. I lived in Monroe for about 20 years, and I realized I hadn't done a very good job of documenting my own hometown. So I've been working on this collection of imagery. They're all black and white images, just a mix of scenes and interesting moments that I've come across. I shot the entire series with my iPhone, so I'm a firm believer in traveling with a camera that's always with you and shooting with that. And
sure.
So I put the exhibit together, and then I realized that what makes Monroe special are the people and the residents here. So I came up with a collection of 13 residents, a mix of people who are natives, people who moved to Monroe, and I spent about an hour or so interviewing these folks and capturing their stories about Monroe, and got a whole new perspective about the history and different reasons why people love this town. So I've woven their quotes throughout the exhibit, so I'm really happy to be featuring these subjects and very thankful to collaborate with them.
That's great. Now, is there any quote that you like the best, or any photo that you like the best? One piece that you really felt like captured the collection?
I think for me, the value of the imagery is in the sum of all of the images. And I say that because there is no one view that truly represents Monroe to me.
Sure.
That said, there is an image that is my favorite, and it's an image of a little boy driving his bicycle beneath a tractor trailer. And it was parked out behind the old Monroe High School. And there was something about that resilience and just childlike daredevil act that felt a little bit like defiance, which was kind of nice, and very natural. He was very much himself and just having fun, and you know, I love that. So that's my favorite image. But
So the power then is in the collection of photographs. And is there a way that people, if they wanted to get this collection, could, if they didn't just want an individual piece?
Yes. So in putting the pieces together, I love the idea of people being able to leave with all the images and to have a documentary that just represented Monroe. So I created a book. And in the photo book, I actually have more images than are featured here in the exhibit. And people can buy that book here at the Art Guild and online. And then 20% of the proceeds of the profits go to the Art Guild.
And we appreciate that. Now, do you have a website that people could go visit to see more of your work?
Mm-hmm. Sure. My website is stephaniecalabrese.com. And you can see all my documentary work there.
Well, great. Thank you so much for showing here, Stephanie. I know that I love the show, and I hope a lot of people get to see it. I know we've got a great write-up in the paper as well. And there's all the other artists that you've worked with and helped collaborate this whole Monroe Celebrates Photography. So thank you so much for your help.
Yeah, thanks for helping me and having it.
Absolutely. Well, the show's great, and I hope you guys get a chance to come down and see it.
Hi, I'm Renee Haraga. I'm with the Click Photo Group. We're the ladies traveling together on a photographic journey. We meet once a month on Thursdays at the Monroe Art Guild at 6:30 p.m. It's open to any photographer the ages 18 or older who has an interest in photography at any level. We have been to the group for several years and originally started out of a church at Orchard Church. And currently we are showing for the month of October, from October 3rd to October 30th, at the Wayfair Hotel Sunroom at 112 North Broad Street in downtown Monroe.
Just wanted to remind everybody that October 10th, Oktoberfest, will be happening here in Monroe. The Art Guild will have several different activities and character drawings that you can come down and enjoy, as well as a show that's going on over at the Mill that will have a lot of our artists from the Art Guild featuring their work in a place that you can be able to purchase it for great Christmas gifts.
We're so excited to be here today in Social Circle at Clearview Primary Care. The new medical facility down here in Social Circle, one of Clearview's branch offices, medical facilities. So first of all, before we turn it over to James with Clearview and Sandy, we want to give Mike Miller a chance to say something on behalf of the City of Social Circle.
I'd like to thank everyone for being out here this afternoon. We always enjoy being here with our public, but also I want to thank Sandy for being here, and I am a patient, and welcome to Social Circle.
Very good. Thank you so much, Mike. We do also have our state representative, Bruce Williamson, here. Would you like to say anything?
Well, sure. Didn't know I was going to say anything.
But you always will.
I'm excited about this new healthcare facility, you know, as we all strive to bring more jobs and opportunities to Walton County. One of the major things that any big employer is going to be looking for is not only the low taxes, the quality of life, but one of the big amenities they want to know is, if we make a huge capital investment in the local community, what kind of quality health care are we going to get? And we're thankful that Clearview's got this beautiful new hospital out in over in the center of our county. And now down in the jewel of the Southern Walton Social Circle, we've got this beautiful, very convenient new facility at Clearview Medical Center here. So we're grateful for this investment, James, and thank you for all you're doing to help drive the quality of life, and your company's driven to drive the quality of life and good health care in Walton County for our citizens.
It's our pleasure. Thank you.
Thanks so much.
Very good.
Glad to be here.
Thank you so much, Bruce. So James Machado, the CEO of Clearview, is now going to give us a few words.
Yeah, I want to thank everyone for coming out. You know, this has been a long time coming for the team at Clearview. This is at least over a year in the works. You know, we first came down here over a year ago, and we had some conversations with local leadership, local government, and industry, and the conversation was about a lack of medical presence in this part of the county. There have been some practitioners in the past that have been here on a long-term basis, but some have come, some have gone, and they wanted something a little more consistent and specifically something that are geared towards their needs, meaning occupational health, especially for the industry. So, you know, we certainly saw the need, and we wanted to be the ones that met that need, and you know, lo and behold, we came across this beautiful space here out in front of Abbey Hospice, and while it took the least longer to get done than we had hoped, I think everyone will agree that the finished product is beautiful. It's certainly right size for the community, and we're thrilled with the initial response from the community. So on behalf of Clearview and everyone who's part of the project, I want to thank everyone here for your support in getting this done, and we're thrilled to be here long term to serve the community of Social Circle. So I'd love to turn it over to Sandy Hopp, who's our lead practitioner here at the center, and she'll be able to tell you more.
Well, I do appreciate all of your support. I mean, it's neat to have all of these great folks from Social Circle. Joe, I appreciate you taking the time to come out. I've grown up with the sheriff here, and so it's neat to have this support out here. But I think that what I've enjoyed doing out here, Terry, is just being able to be a part of this community and to begin to meet the healthcare needs. It's neat to be able to take care of those 10-day-old folks up to 99, and that's what we all do. I am just a piece of this wonderful pie out here. Marcy Perry, that works the front desk, Lori Cardwell, these are the guys that have been the smiles that have helped this community kind of feel comfortable coming in here. And we just hope that we're just beginning to start the process of delivering quality health care to this community.
Very good. Sandy, why don't you go ahead and give them your office hours?
We're open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. We're on call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and we do have a great patient portal, so a great way to access us via the internet. So it's a great way, I think, for people to feel comfortable. They can get their labs via the internet. They can get information that way as well on our Clearview Primary Care website.
Very good. And phone number?
770-267-8462.
Okay, very good. Well, congratulations to you. As I told you on the way on the drive down, I was thinking, I don't remember when I didn't know Sandy. So I know our girls went to preschool together, and now they're in their mid-20s. So
that's right.
Anyway, so congratulations to
you
on being able to run the clinic here, and congratulations to Clearview, and we appreciate your partnership. You want to go outside and cut the ribbon?
Oh, sure.
Okay.
Hello, it's a beautiful day in Monroe, Georgia. We're here downtown at Peyton Pettis Estate Farm at his new location, Grand Opening, and it's a gorgeous place, so be sure to stop by. And Peyton, I just first want to say thank you. You have been a longtime member of the Chamber, past president, and you just stayed involved, and this means a lot to us, and we do appreciate that. And so we are so glad to have you, but we're glad to have you right here in downtown. So tell us a little bit about the
Sure,
your
Carrie.
Office.
Thank you. We're very excited to be here. It's been a dream of mine to get downtown for many years. This is our third ribbon cutting, believe it or not. So that's partially probably I'm a glutton for punishment, and partially we had some growth issues, and those are good problems to have. So we've grown into this office. We needed the space. The Sanders family's here. I want to recognize them and tell them thank you so much for working with us on the space. We love it. It's fantastic. And we're just excited to be here. I do want to brag a little bit on my team. Number one, I wanted to give thanks to my wife, Angie, this could not be possible without putting this together. And she put all the work in. So love you very much. Thank you. Aww. All right, now this is gonna take a couple minutes. So I'm gonna introduce my team. Try not to screw this up, okay? So I've got Allie Mangum, who just started recently. She's in my Loganville location. I have back there Jeff Washington, who just started recently, is an acquisition producer over in my Loganville location. All right, I've got Jessica McCauley, who's gonna be moving to my Loganville location. She's in sales support. Scott Harden in the back, part of my acquisition team in Monroe. Blake Dalton, part of my acquisition team in Monroe. Whitney Smith, who's one of my long-term folks here, been here 5-6 years now. All right, so I'm close. All right, knew I'd butcher something. She's in administration in my Monroe office. Adam Reimer, who's a producer and acquisition over in my Loganville office. All right, I've got Tom Evans, who is my financial services representative. He services both locations. All right, I've got, you're killing me. Ryan Lacey, I'm sorry. He's a fraternity brother of mine too, imagine that. All right, Ryan just started here about a month ago. He's a producer in an acquisition in my Monroe office. Tammy Brown, my stalwart. She's been in administration here for 10 years now in my Monroe office. Laura Duffy, Laura is my bank specialist over in the Loganville office, but also serves both offices. Drew Bowen, who is a producer in acquisition. Gosh, Drew Royal. All right, I'm sorry, I know Drew Bowen. I just talked to him today. Drew Royal, who's also an acquisition over in my Monroe office, or my Loganville office. Chase Stevens, my sales leader, who's been in sales with me now for a good 4 years. He'll probably be looking at his own agency here in the next year or so. He's probably more than ready, I would imagine. He's in my Monroe office. Tiffany Armour is my external marketing specialist. She serves both of my offices here in this county and the surrounding counties. Alicia Smith, who's my internal marketing here in Monroe. Jessica Strickler, who is my internal administration here in Monroe and has been with me for, I guess, going on...
Almost a year.
Yeah, over. Almost a year now. Okay. Dion Martin, who's been with me now for, we're looking at 4 months now, and she's an acquisition specialist over at my Loganville office. And Carly Lambros, who's a producer here in my Monroe office and has been with me now for roughly 5 months. Is that pretty close?
Yeah,
all right, so I'm pretty close.
That's a big
all right.
Deal.
So as you guys can see, probably not the most traditional State Farm agency, right? The old agent with a couple folks sitting around them. We set out with pretty big dreams and visions 15 years ago when we came to Walton County. This team, you might not realize this, okay, but this team is ranked in the top 20 in the country of 19,000 State Farm agents. So I cannot tell you, we are all about team, are we not? And we don't do things without each other's help and support. And so we're just really thankful to everything that the Chamber's done over the years. We could not have done what we do without my participation with the Chamber, the support the Chamber has given me. We're just ready to get involved and just give back to the community. That's what we're here for. So a couple things I did want to keep you guys aware of. Two things coming up. Open enrollment. So I'm a salesperson, I had to get my plug in. All right. Health insurance open enrollment, and this is serious, starts in November. So State Farm went out and partnered with Blue Cross Blue Shield this year, which is an extreme partnership, two of the biggest insurance companies in the world. So that starts open enrollment in November. So if you have any questions, concerns, please just call. We can set an appointment. The guys can meet with you. I have 10 licensed professionals to talk about the health insurance side of things. That's gonna be a big deal going into open enrollment for 2016. And then the second thing I did want to mention is October 20th. If you can write that date down, we're having our first Social Security seminar. I have a seminar room upstairs that can house up to 20 people that we're gonna open up to the community to make connections within the community. But the first one's gonna be the Social Security seminar. Extremely beneficial, educates folks on how to maximize their benefits, taxation, spousal benefits, et cetera. It's exciting. I've got a consultant, Cliff Bonds, that's gonna be coming in running that meeting. He's excellent. So call and sign up for that. Dinner's included, so this is free. We're not gonna try to peddle any products on you. So that's all I've got. Just want to say thank you, and
thank
I appreciate everything.
Your business hours?
I do. office hours are Monday through Thursday, 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. All right, Friday is 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., and Saturday from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. Okay, we also, all these guys give out their cell phones, right?
Yes.
And they work non-traditional hours, so they're available by cell phone. So this is truly a dynamic team. We're very appreciative to be in Walton County, and thank you so much.
One more thing, your address, just in case somebody...
Yeah, sure. What is our address? 110 North Broad Street. 110 North, and we're in the old Sanders Furniture Building. You can still see the sign up there. It's going nowhere. This is a historic building, and we're going to preserve that on the building. So just look for the Sanders Building.
Very good. Well, again, thank you. And
thank
welcome
you.
Downtown.
Thanks for having
go
us.
Go outside and cut your ribbon.
All right, appreciate it.
Good morning. It's October the 2nd, and we are here in downtown Monroe, here at Posh Boutique. And we're here with Jennifer. First, want to tell you thank you so much for your membership with the Chamber.
We are so excited to be a part of it.
Very good. Thank you. We also have Larry here with the City of Monroe.
Mommy.
I think he wants to say a couple of things.
Jennifer, I just wanted to tell you on behalf of the City of Monroe and representing the council here today that we're just thankful for you to be here in downtown Monroe.
We are so excited.
I think it's it already shows me how successful you're going to be because I've noticed the ladies here for the ribbon cutting are already buying clothes.
I'm thankful for that too.
So welcome to downtown Monroe.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Larry. Appreciate that. So tell us a little bit about your shop.
So our boutique, we sell women's clothing and accessories. We sell a lot of fall stuff right now. We have a lot of cute stuff coming in as well. We have a game day section, people getting ready to go to Georgia games. Scarves, blanket scarves are a big seller this season. About it right now.
And then we
have tons of orders coming in. I just got one yesterday, have another one coming in today. So we get really excited about new orders.
And I think you've got some important people you really want to announce.
Yes.
Who they are and recognize.
This is my husband, Ryan Lemons.
Hey.
He is also the owner of Top Dog Contracting behind us by Potluck. This is Camden. He's not happy, but he's 6 weeks old. And this is Brennan. He is almost 2. And this is my mom, Cindy. And these are Marsha, Ryan's sister, Crystal, Ryan's sister, Beth, Ryan's mom, and my best friend, Elizabeth Richardson.
Very good. Well, excited. Well, tell us your store hours.
Okay, so we are open from Monday through Saturday, 11 to 7 until Friday, and then Saturday we're open 10 to 7.
And your address?
And our address is 122 North Broad Street, downtown Monroe. Yeah. And our telephone number is 404-323-7588. We also have a Facebook and an Instagram, and you just go to Shop Posh Clothing, and you can find us on both.
Very
and
good.
We announce new arrivals on both of those.
Excellent. Well, again, thank you again. We're
thank
excited
you.
For you, and we'll go cut the ribbon. You ready?
Yay, I'm all excited. Right. Let's do it.
All right.
2, 3.
There you go.
Yay!
Advocacy Board presents the Haunted House of Addictions. This year it will be held at the Old Loganville Middle School on 152 McCullers Drive, October the 16th, 17th, 23rd, 24th, and 30th from 7 to 10. Saturday, October the 10th is Paws in the Park. It's a 5K run and then a 2K run with dog. The 2K run begins at 8:45, but registration begins at 7:30, so get out there early. And this is a fundraiser to raise funds for the Children's Dog Park. Also on Saturday, October the 10th, is the Monroe Fall Festival from 10 to 4. So after you enjoy some time with your pet at Children's Dog Park, come out to downtown Monroe.
Hello Walton County, this is Kevin Little with Chairman's Report on Channel 16, Walton Entertainment. Today I'm standing in front of the historic courthouse downtown Monroe, and thanks to you, the voters, over the last 6 to 8 months, we've been doing a lot of enhancement downtown around the courthouse and within the courthouse, and we've upgraded the roof, we've redone all the windows, caulking the windows and refixing those to where they'll be energy efficient. And right now we're working on some planters out the sidewalk here where you'll have flowers year round. That way when people are traveling across the country and they come through Monroe, Georgia, they can look at it and say, wow, you know, it's a nice facility here. And then we've got new sod that City of Monroe Downtown Development Authority helped put in back in the spring. And so it's something we're really excited to have here. The old courthouse in Walton County, they were originally three in the state of Georgia. One in Hall County, the one in Walton County, and one in Hancock. The one in Hall County was destroyed by a tornado in the 40s. And the one in Hancock County was just destroyed by fire here a year or so ago. And it's currently being rebuilt. And so we have the only courthouse from that era in Georgia that's still around from that same architect. So it's something we want to preserve and keep for many years to come here in the county. July of 2014, I moved the chairman and the clerk and the purchasing agent back to the old courthouse. Judge Sorrells, who had been here for a lot of years as chief judge, was helping to move this back up here. I'm actually in his old office here in the courthouse, and this gives the citizens more of an opportunity to see it. We have our board meetings in the courtroom, and so the courtroom is put back in its old historic state that was where it was for a long time, and just to see the beauty and the architect that you have here in this old courthouse. Buildings that are built today just don't have the beauty that they had way back then. And so talking back about the Hancock County and the Walton County Courthouse, ironically, they used the Hancock County Courthouse pictures to refurbish this building here in the 90s, and now they're taking the pictures of the Hancock County building that we used here to redo the one in Hancock County. So that, I don't know what the time pattern is for that courthouse to be back in its state, but we're looking forward to going to see that. So over the next 6 to 8 months, you're going to see a lot of more changes and things that's going on here around the courthouse square. We've had to put in several new oak trees because of the old ones were in bad shape and could cause danger to the citizens. And so we will have to constantly monitor these older oak trees around here, because as you know, an oak tree will die from within and it'll be holler on the inside and we not even know anything about it. So we have to constantly have those reviewed. And so, but we're just something to be proud of here in the county. We've got this historical marker, and it's a place where people can come and see history, and it's just been fun to have. And just wanted to talk to you a little bit about it today and let you know what was going on. So if you're downtown Monroe, come in, take a tour of the courthouse, and if you have any questions, we'll maybe can answer them for you. But if you have any questions about county business or anything going on, please give me a call at 770-267-1316. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Kenny Sargent with Keep Walton Beautiful and the Walton County Recycling Center. I want to thank you all for tuning in today. Around here, it's really been all about Rivers Alive. We're getting everything together for that. It will be October the 10th, so when I do the next video, I hope to have a report on Rivers Alive. So that's what we've been doing, getting supplies ready. We're looking forward to being out on the roads to any of you that may see this before October the 10th. Did want to remind you guys that there will be over 300 volunteers out cleaning the roads that day, so be on the lookout for them. They'll be all over the county cleaning up. Another thing that we're in the middle of planning and this coming up is our America Recycles Day. That's going to be on November the 14th, Saturday, November 14th, and this year we're going to be doing a document destruction. We'll do the paint collection as we've been doing for the last couple years, and we'll also be doing the shoe recycling again. So we do ask anyone that brings in paint or documents to be destroyed to also bring a pair of shoes. We have a young high schooler here that's big with the shoe recycling program and our events. He's kind of worked with us at several different events that you guys may already, you know, have seen before, and we get him a lot of his shoes at our events. So we want to keep that going. It really is for a good cause. And I also wanted to remind everyone that on that Saturday, November 14th, that our scales will be down. It will be all about recycling on America Recycles Day. So we will have our scales closed down on that Saturday for trash disposal. I want to make sure and stress to get that word out there. So you guys will know and won't pull up expecting us to be open. For trash disposal will be closed that day. Except for green bag trash, the compactor will be open for all green bags, and the recycling drive-thru will be open. We'll be open for all recycling. So that's coming up. That's what we've been working on. If you have any questions about America Recycles Day or want information about Rivers Alive, feel free to give us a call, 770-267-1421. We're here Monday through Friday, 7:30 to 4. So just give us a call. And like I always do, I want to encourage you guys to come out and see the center here if you've never been out before. We'd be happy to show you what we do, what your recycling options are here in Walton County, and answer any environmental questions you have. So come on out and see us. Again, our number is 770-267-1421. Give us a call with any questions, and we'll see you guys next time.
Hi, I'm Molly Kimmler with the Walton County Extension, and I want to talk to you again today about Walk Georgia. Yes, it's still around, and I'm plugging at it every day. Walk Georgia is still in Georgia with over 50,000 people participating in Walk Georgia over the years. This is a website that you can go on and log on your activity. You can walk, you can work out at the gym, you can vacuum your house, you can run in the 5K races we've got going on in Walton County. You can do senior Zumba. You can push a lawnmower. You can play softball. You can take care of your children. And there is much, much more you can check on the Walk Georgia website. It is a virtual walk, and the map is back. Everybody's been asking, where is the map? Where is the map? Well, it is back now, and you can go. I've already gone through about six counties, I think, now. So, and I'm learning a little bit about every county. So that's always great to know. It's a great way to sit down with your children, let them participate in Walk Georgia, and find out about Georgia. How wonderful. Walk Georgia is now based on points. We still have the miles and the hours and minutes and things like that, but it is taking points based off METs. That's the metabolic equivalence. And so the University of Georgia has gone through, because people were fussing, they go, you know, yoga or running, it's so different. So now that's why we're doing the points, and we're doing everything on points now. I was in a meeting not long ago because I'm on the state task force with Walk Georgia, and I was with Dr. Murray. She's the Associate Dean for the Extension and Outreach in the University of Georgia Family Consumer Sciences. And this was a quote she said, and I thought it was really good. She said, "To me, the beauty of Walk Georgia is that it meets people where they are because it's a community-based. There's something for everyone. People can form groups. They can do this individually. It doesn't matter." We used to do 8 and 12 weeks. Now it's continuous. So all of your points just keep accumulating and keep accumulating. And we have several people that are doing Walk Georgia, and they've been doing it for many years now. And since last January, their points have really accumulated. But what we're wanting to do here in Walton County eventually is to do our own little thing. And we can do that now. For an example, Walton government, they did it in the spring, and we just blocked off a time, and we can do that with their administrator. We can block off time from month to month, and they can have their own little contest. So that can happen with schools, with businesses, with anything here in Walton County. We can do that. The Coca-Cola Foundation has given Walk Georgia $1 million grant. All of that went to helping with administration, with publicity, with our website, and all kinds of things like that. The website, you can use it on your desktop. You can use it on whatever devices you have. I've even got it on my cell phone now. So I can go on my cell phone and plot and add my miles that I'm doing on there, on my activity. Some of the things that you can get, you get a newsletter when you're doing Walk Georgia. In this newsletter, you get wellness articles, recipes that are very healthy and very good for us. We have a Facebook, Twitter, we have Instagram, we have all kinds of things that are real popular now with a lot of the young people. So what we want to do is we want to go on to the Walk Georgia website, and we can just go to walkgeorgia.org, and then you can log on and create your account, and you and hundreds of other people here in Walton County can participate. If you'll participate and you stop by and I can see what you're doing, I might even give you a little incentive for participating, like a water bottle or maybe a bracelet to wear, or I've got several things. This is really cool. I have my little Walk Georgia, and I have my little business cards in there. So that's a cool little item that I've ordered. So if you want to come by and pick up something, or if you are a business, want to do Walk Georgia as a group, a large group, let me know. The seniors over in Walton County with the rec department, we have some of those participating. They do some great activities over there. I know we've got coming up the Paws in the Park. I'll be there for Paws in the Park. And I'm trying to get to some of the health affairs and things. So if you know something, call me. I'll be glad to come out and promote Walk Georgia. But like I said, it's a wonderful program. The university is doing a great job with it, and I just really encourage you to participate in Walk Georgia. I'm going to show you a little thing on my computer and how to log on, and you can log on, and then we'll cut there. But anyway, I hope that you too will go on to Walk Georgia and begin to be healthier. We want to live longer and be healthier, eat better, and try to be able to see our children and grandchildren grow up. That's my goal, to see my grandchild grow up. So remember, go on to walkgeorgia.org and set up your account. If you have any questions, give me a call, 770-267-1324, and we will try to answer your questions. So go on, let's get healthier and let's get out and walk. When you get started with Walk Georgia, you're going to see the first page you'll see will be log on. If you have an account, you log on to that account. but also you can create your account. And it's very self-explanatory about how to set up your account. I'll just go on my account right quick and show you how it works. All right, this is what your first page looks like. You can log on your activity. You can see I've already gotten over 4,600 points, 99 miles, 55 hours. Some of the things I've been doing, I do a lot of walking. That's what most of mine is walking. Now, I went to the beach this week, so I'm gonna log on my activity, and I walked. All right, and let's say I walked 30 minutes. Well, easy, I thought walking in the sand and things like that was a little difficult, so I went on and I put somewhat difficult and then submitted it. And it will tell me, cool, take me to my map, nice activity, or I can go back to my activity, and you can add as many things on there per day as you want to. So you can add like walking and your gym work or whatever, but then you can go to your map. Now I'm ready to go into one more county now. So hopefully, my only complaint is I hope they get the map a little bit bigger for people to see. So anyway, but this is very easy to do. I mean, just set up your account. It's just very easy. And if you have any questions, just give me a call. I'll be glad to help you through it or work with a group, either one.
Hi, I'm Amy Honeywell with the Partnership for Families, Children, and Youth, and I'm here with my spider friends to remind you about our annual Haunted House of Addictions. This year, we are going to be over at Loganville Middle School, the old Loganville Middle School, located at 152 Clark McCullers Road. We're going to be there October 16th, 17th, 23rd, 24th, and 30th, from 7 to 10 each night. Come out and join the Youth Advocacy Board as we celebrate healthy choices and healthy lives all month long in October, but especially during our Haunted House of Addictions. We'll have over 50 volunteers coming out to haunt our house, and of course, our Demon of Addiction will be there yet again. We're changing it up this year. You'll see a lot of new things going on at the Haunted House, as well as our new location. We'll have new storylines, we'll have some more spiders, and we will definitely have ghouls and different addictions showing themselves throughout the Haunted House this year. We will be talking a lot about recovery and hope for people who have who live in addiction or have experienced addiction, but we definitely want to talk about how to prevent addiction, and that is what our whole Haunted House is about. So we hope that you come and join us 7 to 10 each night. It's $3 for children or students, and it's $5 for adults to come on out. If you want to learn more about the Haunted House or maybe how you can volunteer, we're accepting teen volunteers and adult volunteers this year. Visit our website. It's www.waltonyouthcan.org. You can also visit the portion that says Paint Walton Red as well, and that will give you information about how to volunteer and just even more information about the Haunted House itself. So we look forward to having you at our annual Haunted House of Addictions. We hope to see you there. Bye.
Loganville will be celebrating its 18th annual Trick or Treat in downtown Loganville on Saturday, October the 31st from 4 till 6. It is open to children second grade or younger. Donut Dash. It is a 5K run walk and a 1 mile fun run Saturday, November the 7th at 9 o'clock. On-site registration and check-in begins at 8 a.m. at the Loganville High School on 100 Trinit Trail off of Highway 78 in Loganville. All proceeds for the Donut Dash benefit the Walton County Special Olympics. So come out on November the 7th for a 5K run walk and a 1 mile fun run to raise money for the Walton County Special Olympics.
Hi, this is Jody Johnson. I'm here to do the Recreation Report. Today I have Joey Logan, here with me, and he is our newest member of the recreation team. And one of his tasks is to come in and work with our soccer program, youth, and hopefully to start up some things with the adults as well. So thanks, Joey, for coming on today, and tell us a little bit about the soccer program. I know it's somewhat, you're in your infancy stage, been here a little over a month, and but you've hit the ground with your feet running and got our soccer program headed in the right direction. So tell us a little bit about the soccer program.
Yeah, Jody, we're doing really well. Have currently 217 kids signed up right now, three select teams, several big age groups this year. Looking forward to starting my big project, which is winter futsal, coming up this winter. That's going to be a huge thing. I think it's going to be a big hit with our program.
So futsal is, tell us, what is futsal?
Futsal is essentially small-sided soccer. It's indoor soccer. It's going to take place in the Now gym. It's going to be basically the same outline as a basketball court. Built up goals. It's going to be nice inside and the air conditioning. It's going to be a nice league for us.
Or heat, however, whatever the weather is in this wintertime. So that's a good idea. And you play with what type of ball? Because it's in a basketball gym.
Well, you play with the futsal ball. It's still a size 5. It's a little bit smaller compared to a regular regulation size soccer ball. It's about a size 4.
Okay, and it doesn't bounce, sir?
No, sir. Just hits the ground and kind of dies. The extra padding on there helps that, so not really going to break anything or fly too far.
Well, that's great. Tell us a little bit about the youth side soccer. You know, we have 217 kids, and you usually range anywhere from around 300, 400 kids in the come springtime. What are some of the highlights of our youth soccer program?
Well, youth soccer program is growing. Really looking forward to next season as well. We're building up a program again and getting kids excited about playing for Walton County and not going elsewhere.
Okay. And I know there's different levels of soccer, whether it's rec level or premier level, and what's the differences in those?
The difference between recreation and select is essentially just the competition that you're playing. Recreational is more, you know, getting skills down, having a lot of fun. Select is more competitive. You're playing for wins and losses. You're playing for trophies. That's basically the differences between the two leagues.
Well, I know we certainly are going in the right direction, and one of the things we're always in need of, well, two of the things we're always in need of is volunteer coaches, and we have a pretty good training program for that as well. How would someone get involved in coaching, and what type of training opportunities are there?
Anybody who'd like to volunteer, I'd encourage, if you have a son or daughter, please, you know, coach them too as well. Stay on with them through as many years as you can. The more you develop your kid yourself, the more you get to develop the team too as well. Our training program is going to be probably revisited. It's very detailed and very organized, but also very fun and relaxed as well.
And the second thing that I know is in need of across the state and across the nation is for soccer officials. And that's a good opportunity for most young kids to learn the skills at a young age, because that the soccer is one sport that we do have and do allow younger kids. I believe you have to be how much older than the league you're participating in?
Depends on your certification, really, the level. But I think the earliest you can start refereeing is 11 or 12. So you can start doing U8 games. I believe it's 4 to 5 years of age. Going up from there, it also depends on competition level too as well. But for the most part, 4 or 5 years older than the oldest age group is what you can be refereeing.
Which is great. Most of our other sports, our baseball and softball and football, usually we have 18 and older for our working officials. And they get paid very well to do that. It's a great to learn how to be a soccer official. And when you do go off to college or go back and you're in your hometown, you can always find a secondary job. So it's a good thing to learn how to do. Well, we appreciate you coming in, talking about our soccer program. We'll have you on here periodically to keep us updated on how our soccer program is doing. I will let the viewers know we are registering for our basketball, which is our winter sports programs. Right now, we're registering, so if, by the time this is viewed, you probably have missed basketball registration, but go by our office, call, and see if we still have any spots available. Once registration ends, then we'll fill as needed into our program. Last year, we had over 1,000 kids playing youth basketball, so we had a ton of kids that wanted to play. And registration as of now is looking really, really well. It looks like we may even go further than the 1,000 that we had last year. Also, we invite you to come to our community centers. They're still open usually from 6 in the morning until 8 at night, with the exceptions of Wednesday and Saturday. They're abbreviated times, and then of course we're closed on Sunday. But get in, it's a great value. It's a great place to work out. It's a nice, clean, family place to come and work out. Stay healthy, and we invite you to come do that. Come and visit some of our community centers here at Felker Park and at Meridian Park. So again, thanks a lot, Joey, for coming and being our guest on the show this week. And until next time, and remember, sportsmanship starts at home.
Hey there, I'm Joey Sulkowski, head football coach at Monroe area, coming to you for our weekly installment of post-game wrap-up from previous week's games. This past week we traveled up to Toccoa, Georgia to take on Stevens County, and what looked to be a fairly wet game with all the rain and storms we've had over the last 2 weeks. It was a pretty bad playing surface that we had to play on, but we actually played the majority of the game rain-free, so that was a definite positive. Came up short 29-6. Played very, very well in the first half. You know, it was 7-6 going in at halftime, and thought we were in good position, and just made a couple mistakes in the second half, and it really cost us in the grand scheme of things. In the final outcome of the game, we turned the ball over three times on three consecutive plays in the second half, and that really sealed the deal for us in terms of where we were at. Also turning the ball over in Stevens County territory, in which they turned into three scores off of those turnovers. So that ultimately was what cost us in the long run. Looking forward to this week, moving on, we've got North Oconee coming into town at home. It'll be our homecoming game. Got games here all this week. We're very excited about that. We've got our Carver Middle School football team that'll be home at Wednesday, taking on Monticello. We've got our junior varsity team that'll be home on Thursday, taking on Heritage High School from Conyers. And then with the homecoming game on Friday, a lot of festivities going on. Got a parade downtown on Thursday. And some other things going on Friday at the game with our homecoming court and all the pageantry that goes along with that. So definitely excited about that, and just hitting that mid-season lull right now where we've got some guys that are hurt and banged up, a little injured. So just working towards that, and I think we're moving in the right direction still and are in a good place to still battle for a pretty good playoff spot coming out of our region. So hope to have everybody come out to the game this Friday. Weather's going to be great, and I thank you for your time.
Hi there, I'm Emily Russell with Clearview Regional Medical Center. Thanks so much for tuning in today. As always, we're happy to have you join us and learn something new about what's going on in our medical community. Today, we are so blessed to have with us Ms. Tiffany Welch. Tiffany is a certified physician's assistant, and she joins us effective September the 1st. So welcome, Tiffany. We're so glad to have you.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
So Tiffany, where did you complete your training at?
I originally completed my training at Howard University in Washington, D.C.
Very good. Wonderful. So you've been a PA for how long?
I've been a PA now for almost 20 years.
Wonderful. So lots of experience. I'm sure you've seen all sorts of different kinds of things out there.
Yes.
Very good. Now, you're coming to us most recently from Florida.
Yes.
And you relocated your family up here with you. And she's joined the Clearview team, part of the Clearview primary care team. So we're so glad to have you. So coming from Florida, did you practice as a PA in Florida mostly before coming here?
I did. A wealth of family practice and pediatric experience.
Very good, very good. So when it comes to family practice, what are some of your favorite conditions to treat, favorite patients to treat? What's kind of your niche?
My passion is women's health and pediatrics.
Fantastic. Yes. And women's health, I mean, that can include everything from an annual pap smear to what else? Yes.
Any gynecological needs. I also enjoy minor surgery, in-office surgery, so any abscess and drainage, concerning skin lesions, I'd be happy to take care of those.
Very good. And then as far as pediatrics go, any ages or?
I treat the cradle to the grave.
Fantastic. Wonderful. You know, in primary care, that's so important that you have a primary care practitioner that truly follows you and help manage your care, helps manage your medications, and really just manages your overall health. And that's why primary care is so important. Do you think that people today actually keep a primary care provider, or what kind of trends have you seen?
Well, there has definitely been an increase in preventative care measures, which is so vitally important. If we can get you at the beginning and take care of some of those preventative measures, it can keep you out of the hospital and off a lot of chronic care meds a lot of times.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well, and being here in the South, you know, we drink a lot of sweet tea and eat a lot of fried chicken. So what are some of the chronic diseases that you see come up most often?
Of course, you know, in our nation, obesity is on the rise, and along with obesity comes diabetes, high cholesterol, high blood pressure.
So if somebody thinks that perhaps they're on the verge of experiencing one of those chronic conditions, I mean, do they have to have a referral to see a primary care provider? How does that work?
No. As long as we'll be happy to see anybody, insured or uninsured, and we can kind of make those decisions once you come in and help you get your healthcare needs taken care of.
Absolutely. You know, that's the great thing about primary care is that we can treat lots of different things, and we can kind of help be the point guard, so to speak, and then you can refer out to different specialists as necessary and as needed. So if you don't have a primary care provider and you're looking right now, we would love to have you as part of our Clearview primary care family. Tiffany is seeing patients of all ages, like she said, all the way from newborns all the way up, just providing that basic primary care that everybody needs to have, especially if you don't have a primary care provider that you're seeing already. Please give us a call. We would love to help you out with that. We have multiple locations all around Walton County. We have a clinic in Social Circle and two clinics here in Monroe and a clinic in Grayson as well over in Gwinnett County. So if there's anything we can do to help you, please let us know. If you're interested in joining one of our Monroe clinics here, just give us a call at 770-267-8464. We would love to see you and treat anything that you might have going on, even if you just don't feel good. What about the cold, sniffles, allergies, that kind of stuff?
Any type of acute care, we'd be happy to take care of that for you. Come to us before you go to your ER.
Absolutely. It's a good thing to stay out of the ER. You know, going to a primary care provider is a lot cheaper, number one, and is better suited for things like that. We can get you in and out fairly quickly. We're a lot of times able to do same day appointments. So give us a call if you're not feeling well. We can absolutely get you in to see Tiffany or one of her coworkers here with Clearview Primary Care. So as always, keep yourself healthy. Focus on what you need to do to manage whatever you might have going on, managing diet, exercise, etc. If there's anything we can do to help you here at Clearview, don't hesitate to give us a call. If you're also looking for a physician, whether it be primary care or otherwise, we have a physician referral line that you can always call. And the number for that is 1-877-933-2762. And then the third Friday of every month, we have Senior Bingo right here in the cafeteria. So we'd love to see you third Friday of every month at 10 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in and stay healthy.
We printed them on the blank canvas to bring out the colors in them.
Hey, thanks a lot for tuning in today. As always, we're going to show you the dogs and cats that are available for adoption here at Walton County Animal Control. We've got some great news. There's been the Affordable Pet Clinic that goes on all the time at Tractor Supply in Monroe. It used to be twice a month, but now they're actually doing it every Saturday at Tractor Supply on Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard in Monroe. The clinic times are from 1 to 2:30 p.m. every Saturday. They've got a lot of great prices on there. There's $15 for microchipping, $18 for 3-year rabies vaccines, $10 for heartworm testing. So you want to be sure to take your pets, have them current on those rabies vaccines. We've had a couple occasions this year where a raccoon or a skunk has wandered into a yard and was killed by the family dog, and that skunk tested positive, a raccoon has tested positive for rabies. So if you don't have a rabies shot on your animal, it either has to be put to sleep or put into quarantine for 6 months. So just a quick $18 rabies shot can really take care of that. Plus, it's just the best thing to do. You never know what might happen, what might come up, but keep your pets healthy. There's a lot of inexpensive alternatives around, but it doesn't be going to your regular vet to have annual exams and vaccinations. But maybe you can't afford that, just so you know, at Tractor Supply every Saturday now from 1 to 2:30, and it says no appointment is needed and there's no exam fee as well. And now we're going to show you some of the dogs and cats that are available for adoption here.
This is Bo. He's a four-year-old pointer mix. He's very sweet. He's good with kids. He's already neutered and has all of his vaccines. He's just ready to go to a new home. Come on.
This is Max. He's kind of like a retriever chow mix, maybe male. He's about 2 years old. He's already neutered, housebroken, and really sweet.
This is Marley. She's about 4 years old. She is a lab mix. She's already spayed. I know. She doesn't get along with kids and she doesn't like cats. But if you know someone that's looking for a good dog, other than that, she is a good dog. She needs a home fast.
This guy, he didn't have a name yet, but he's about 8 months old. He's very sweet. He's a male. He's not neutered yet. He will have to be, but he's very, very sweet and loving. Just needs a good home.